clearly am not inside. And sorry I didn't do a video yesterday. I hadn't slept on the Friday night. And I had to do a double shift at work on Saturday. And then I had to go to Westfield. Because that was the only place I could think of that was still open to get somewhere to eat. Oh no, it wasn't. What happened? I don't know. I was in a weird, tired haze. As you are, you know, when you just can't get to sleep. So I'd been awake more than 24 hours. Ridiculous. And I found myself going to Waitrose in Shepherd's Bush. And then. This is like a six-year-old story, isn't it? After going to Waitrose, I realised that was a stupid mistake it was, and I ended up buying just some Jarlsberg cheese. And I thought, oh, maybe I'll have some sandwiches or something when I get home. But then I couldn't get the bus home because it was too busy, and I thought, well, what's the point? I then went into a Sainsbury's local, and I got these, and I was going to do a YouTube video on them, a dead chewy Maynard's Bassett review. This is that they're new, but they've been reduced to, oh no, they're not new, there's no exclamation mark, so it's just new. Clearly for Halloween. They've been reduced to 50p, but when I scanned it for the till, it was 30p. So we'll do this part of the video now. Right, now. Oh, they're individually wrapped. Oh, that's nice. And the different colours as well. There's purple and there's red. Oh, they smell different as well. Oh, in that case, and if I'm doing something outside, I might as well review different flavours at different times. There seems to be loads of the purple ones, though. That's a bit weird. And I'll go through your comments as I'm chewing on them. But if they're too chewy, you might not know. I'll be able to get some flavour at least. Sunday outside last week, yeah. So then I wake up really late. I woke up and it was like 3 in the afternoon. I was like, oh, I'm still really tired now, actually. And I'm watching Columbo on Channel 5 USA. Or 5 USA, as I like to call it. And it's all the same old Columbos. It's always the same ones whenever I turn it on. The two with Leslie Nielsen. Is it Leslie Nielsen? Is that his name? I've still got it on now, actually. Info, is it Leslie Nielsen? You know him out of Naked Gun? Yeah. They've not put it as starring Leslie Nielsen on this. I don't think he was as big at the time. But anyway. Right. Lady in Waiting is the one that's usually on. And Identity Crisis. It always seems to be the same two episodes on at least every weekend. Sunday Outside last week. Comments. I should have got a drink. Oh, I'm really tired. Rebecca Chaffer put, there is something really grounding, homely and cosy about Charlie's videos. Well, today I probably said you all to sleep. I could just go to sleep right now. It's so annoying. Why can't I just sleep when I want to? Videos, and they help with my anxiety. Still annoyed that you were in the shop I work at and I was out the back again. Ah, that was when you was in Watford. I'll see you in Watford, I'm sure, again, Rebecca Trafford. You got a B&M there as well, so that's great. So I meant that in a nice way. No, I'm not saying that I'm only going to go to Watford again because there's a B&M. If I happen to be in Watford again, I'll pop into your shop. Sonia replied, I understand what you mean. I also suffer from anxiety, and Charlie's videos do seem to help. Sort of a calming effect to me. Well, I'm glad everything is so calm. And at that juncture, I'm going to enjoy a sweet. And I'll have the purple one. The purple one's usually the best colour in all sweets, isn't it? Like in Quality Street and Roses. Oh, it's more pink inside there, look. And it's got the indentations of the wrapper. Ooh! Instant flavour. And it's actually... What is that? I'm salivating a lot. Fruit flavoured chews. Lemon, strawberry, apricot and blackberry. Strange. I would have liked lime. Mmm. Very nice. The fruit concentrates includes apricot, strawberry, elderberry. Does the elderberry sell all the berry, other berries to what Mandler elders? I'd totally ruin that joke up. Respect your elders. Apple and orange, blackberry and raspberry and lemon. So does the elderberry sell the blackberry and raspberry to mind your elders, watch your elders, respect your elders? I can't believe I ruined that joke up. May contain milk in bold. So there's calcium in there somewhere. It's all good. Yay. Right. That's enough of that one. So the purple ones are nice. What was that meant to be though? Lemon, strawberry, apricot and blackberry. So it's blackberry. I thought it was blackcurranty sort of flavour, but blackberry. I need to get a tissue. Oh, there's one there. Good. That saves me. I went to get up again. Right. Next one is Brett McLachlan. Are you dancing with the huge leaves? I often wonder what your neighbours makes of your antics, or if they have ever happened to look out the window and see you doing something mad and thought that guy ain't right. Well, I'll tell you what, it certainly saves on sending Christmas cards at Christmas time to your neighbours. And it just stifles any kind of interaction, which I don't mind, which in London's quite normal. Ben Stocks has put, great video as usual, Charlie, but not having a very good week so far, as I've had some bad news about the family friend, and you've kept me smiling as usual, so thanks, mate. Oh, I'm sorry to hear you've had some bad news. And also, that pumpkin had a dent on it, the back, and it was shaped like two arse cheeks. I'd sent you a picture if I knew how. Well, that's just about pumpkins, isn't it? They can look a bit obscene. Sonia's put, Charlie, you should do a dance over Shami for every Sunday outside. Do you know what? I really was gonna, because right here, the tambourine. And if you're wondering how I picked that up, I picked it up with my foot. I'm quite good with my feet. Pick all sorts. Can you do that? I'm always picking stuff up with my feet all the time, you know, instead of bending down and picking up. So old school, do you know what I mean? It's like, I mean, we all come from some kind of ape or something, don't we? So we should be able to use our feet as a tool to pick things up and move things. Just make sure your feet are clean, obviously. It's dark outside now as well. Now that would have looked bizarre, wouldn't it? Me being in the garden shaking a tambourine in the dark. Been normal to me, I would have done it, but like I say, I'm really, really tired and not really feeling 100% at all. The Love of Ed Smith has put, chocolates always tastes better when they're wrapped in paper and foil. I love strawberry creams, and Quality Street seem to do the best ones. I like the strawberry one in Quality Street. I do like more of the chocolates out of Cadbury's Roses though. But I do like certain ones very much in Quality Street. Miniature Eros and Celebrations as well are brilliant. And the judges put, just go to Willesden B&M. I know, I had to go, won't I? I like B&M. And the judges put, you're so funny. Thank you very much. It's just me being a nutter. James Gooden's put, you forgot Celebrations. But from best to worst is Heroes, Celebrations, Quality Street and Roses at the bottom. Ooh, controversy. Or controversy, however you like to pronounce it. And that was all the Sunday Outside comments from last week. Not very many. Well, then I'm going to go to Grenfell Inquiry. That's the video that I did on Monday, before Monday Meander. I've got to do Monday Meander tomorrow as well, and I hope I'm feeling better. Right, Nan comments for this one. I know one of them was man. Craig says, but the inquiry beginning in a couple of months' time will look into those behind the cladding. I still think though that they'll just put all the companies into administration and no one's going to get the blame for anything. Weird noise. I know it's going to start really weird light again. Ben Stocks has put, I will always praise the fire brigade. Had an accident one bonfire night in 2011 at my nana's house. Of bungalows occupied by a 70-plus-year-old set fire and they luckily all got out. Luckily got out thanks to the fire brigade. My dad went inside one of the thick, dangerous smoke. I know they didn't get out alive, but a fireman saved him. They're heroes, not arsonists. I agree, Charlie. This joke is bonkers sometimes. I know, it's really frustrating now. How dare that anyone be blaming the fire brigade for this situation? Judiciary Time Corporate Trademark has put, yeah, I agree, there were five people. I agree that the fire people are one of the best people in the UK that look after people. Do not get me wrong, if there was fail, yeah, fair enough. But it's not that they were shot, that it went on fire again after it was put out. Sorry, JGS, I think... I'll read that again and see if it's not just me just not reading it properly. Yeah, I agree with the fire people. I agree the fire people are one of the best people in the UK that look after people. Do not get me wrong. If it was their fault, yeah, fair enough, but it's not. There was shots that it went on fire again after it was put out. Exactly, it's not the fire brigade's fault, is it? It's just like people being ridiculous. So Meadow Pictures put car pileups because car pileups is what I was saying. He's riffing off my accent. Car pileups. Any word with an I in after the first letter is just going to come as an R. Geeky Meals put a spot on. And Jan Brands put, what do you expect from a Tory government? They'll always find someone else to blame. Filthy slags, a lot of them. That's like any government, no, they'll always find someone else to blame. I mean, the Labour government's no better. All politicians, it's just, ugh. And the fact she got a vote for them, she's like, ugh. They always do you over one way or the other. Munda Meander is my next one. And, I was up really early, wasn't I? Because I didn't go to sleep last week, did I? From Under Meander, I stayed up. Well, I didn't stay up, I just couldn't sleep. So I went out. And it was really early in the morning. I don't think that's going to happen again. Oh, it might do. Because I might just go to sleep again now, because I've got no energy. Well, I have. I've always got energy. I mean, if I felt like it, I'd just go to Bond Street right now and run around Oxford Street and think and say, oh, look at this. But I feel it in my legs and my arms more. Do you know what I mean? My head and everything just wants to go. But it's just like the rest of me, it just wants to hold me back and go to sleep. It's like, no, just move. I hope that makes sense to somebody because it's how I feel. And the back of my eyes wants to go to sleep as well. I just want to do this. Like, I want to go. It's weird. Adam Fitzpatrick has put, I read the title initially as I want to buy a house. Yeah, because I wanted to buy a clothes horse last week, didn't I? Because the dryer's broke. And because it's a shared garden, you're not allowed to put washing lines up to dry your clothes, obviously. So you've got to dry them in your house, which obviously can lead to other problems such as condensation and really high humidity, which is really bad for you. S125 has put, Burger King do breakfasts. Trouble is finding one that's open for it. Do they? I'll have to look into that. Jan Brenner's put, have you ever tried Rohypnol to get those good night's sleep? Apparently it's very effective. Well, if I could get some hold of some, I probably would because I'm sick to death. I'm going to have to go to doctors or something, but I never go to doctors, not because I'm scared of the doctors. It's because I'm never ill. And I know it sounds bizarre, but I wouldn't class this as being ill. I don't feel very well, but I won't class it as being ill. I'm just tired. And I don't know why. I mean, I've been laying off the caffeine and everything for so long. Ever since I did the pot noodle diet, funny enough, I've been drinking no coffee. Much fewer energy drinks. But until very recently, I mean, yesterday, I did have a coffee. Because I needed to stay awake. And then, a couple of days ago, I did have a few energy drinks, but I've not been drinking half as, I just haven't been drinking it, and I feel terrible. I think caffeine really does just keep the world moving. Angela Jones put, I feel the same about food left out. I'm so glad I'm not the only one who feels like that. Yeah, that was when I went into Lidl, innit, and they got all that open food. And It's not good. It was back in the, I think it was the 80s and 90s, people really got put off of open food counters like that. There should be sneeze guards, there should be cupboards. In fact, the co-op, really near, quite close to me, has just refit all their open food stands to have pull-out drawers, so they're covered. I mean, it's still not great, because when it's pulled out, you know, the whole of the food is on show. It's why everything was plastic-coated, you know. Because you have stories and scientists and bloody TV shows was doing tests on food that had been left in these counters and they showed to be covered in bacteria. Little of Ed Smith has put, Charlie, I have too suffered from sleep problems for many years. I've tried everything under the sun to help me as it was driving me crazy. Anyway, long story short, please try magnesium. It really helped me and hope you get something sorted out to help sleep too. I'll try anything, so I'm going to try magnesium then. That means I'll have to pop into Holland and Barrett, sneer at the prices, and see if I can find it somewhere cheaper. okay, then, yeah, I'll try that. Thanks for that, little of Ed Smith. Angela Jones put, I did hear there was an arcade in West 12 now. There's like a casino sort of thing in West 12. It's called something to do with Sherlock Holmes or something on the outside of it. Ben Stocks has put, I reckon them crazy OAPs must have been behind that crash driving on the pavement again. And yeah, because someone crashed into the house. Not this one. The one down the street, road. Geek on Wheels has put, talk proper, lol. I do talk proper. People need to listen carefully. Charlie Littles, but hi, Charlie. Do you still use your Velvetizer from Hotel Chocolate? Been watching your vids on it. I'm treating myself to one as I'm choc-obsessed. It did go into the cupboard over the summertime, but it will be coming out over the wintertime, I'm sure. I will be using other brands of chocolate, and I am going to Hotel Chocolate and pay them prices again. Yeah, it's good chocolate, but they are the only people who make good chocolate. Sonia's put, Charlie, if you cannot sleep, you need to get it looked at. Please register with a local doctor. Oh, gosh, Sonia, I didn't even... It's like you're getting into the future by writing in the past. This is weird. A great Monday meander. I do appreciate the longer videos. That crash where the wall and fence had been damaged, was it near you? Then, if you've heard of it, you should have bought that unicorn mirror. Lidl sell beanies, pumpkin spice, instant coffee. That's random. If I see it, I'll get it. I'm trying to get to Lidl to try it. Do you like pumpkin spice? Did you get your clothes off? I had to laugh at the bit where you said Tesco Express saw the muslin cloths. And you thought it said muslin. And you thought it was the beginning of a joke. Please do not change your accent. I love it. The part when you told us about almost getting knocked down crossing the road because the driver was on a mobile, that is awful. She should have been dealt with. I read in our local news that someone was killed when she crashed into another driver and she'd been on cannabis, but she was let off due to the fact she had a baby. I think she got a community service. That is something that's coming up more often, Sonia, isn't it? About people get let off just because they've got a kid. And it's almost as if the court system is now allowing people to get away with crime just because they've got offspring. It shouldn't be all of... We shouldn't have to take care of that. We shouldn't have to... She should get someone to look after a kid. That should be the punishment. If she can't pay the crime, pay for the childcare costs, okay? Because she needs to know that doing the wrong thing has consequences, and just because she's had a baby does not constitute a get-out-of-jail-free card. Right, it's getting really dark. I think I've got a light plugged in. Oh, I think I have, actually. Bear with me a sec. There we are. That's a bit better, isn't it? A few more lumens. It's great, that word, that, isn't it? I like the word illuminate. Illuminate! Geek on Wheels has put Stone the Crows. And then S125 has put Geek on Wheels Salmon. And that's that. Right, let's try another sweet. I'm going to try a yellow one. Yellow. This is proper words. So this is going to be the lemon one. Now, I'm expecting a good sharp zip of lemon on this. Set to salivate already. Be good if there's some kale in the middle. But there isn't. Sirens in the background. Just a soft lemon flavour. Oh, well. That could have been better. What was the next idea? Boots store closures, my reaction. So Boots are going to be closing a few stores. They announced it a while ago, and I said that you shouldn't be doing it because there's better ways to make money and to be more accessible to customers. But will they listen? I don't think so. But I did tweet it several times. What's with Tees Put? You've missed your calling, Charlie. Your retail knowledge and ideas are brilliant. Thanks very much, What's for Tea. I think there's so many CEOs and there's so many company managers and everything that just take the job for the money and they have absolutely no care in what they're doing. And it's weird because you hear about it in the news, don't you, such as CEO from Marks and Spencer's suddenly joins Vodafone. You know, something like that. Completely different company, 100% night and day changeover. And it's thinking, well, so which job there was the one you were just using to get by, but you put very little effort into, what you didn't put your heart into? I mean, okay, people got to find jobs just like everybody else. So like a sales assistant, for instance, if you want to work in a shop, you're going to want to work in a shop that you're roughly interested in. But if the job comes along that you just need to get a job in, then obviously you go for it. But surely with a CEO, you get to pick and choose a little. I mean, I might be wrong there, but it does bug me when you see these people change from one company to a completely different one, like moving from WH Smith to Royal Mail or something. It's weird. Sonia's put, I completely agree with everything you said. I think it's a fantastic idea. The blush button would be so good, and the lockers too. Exactly. So, because the video's already out there, put lockers in the empty shops. You know, the shops that aren't doing so well. Or in bigger shops. Whatever. Just so somebody could be on the bus one day, on the phone, got an headache, let's get some Nurofen from Boots. And then click it over to the nearest Boots store, they put it in a locker, then you can go in, pick it up. Oh, there's a voucher inside. Oh, I could get 10% off a meal deal today. Job done. Money bought. Money made in the shop as well as online. That's generally what the idea was. Martin Maroney's put, oh my god, didn't even know there was closing most Boots. It's not most Boots, but they'll be closing quite a few. And it won't be long till the standalone Boots opticians will be shoved into the next nearest Boots. I thought it was a good store still. It is good, but just like all companies now, they're all just launching CVAs just to try and get to pay less rent. Gonna need to start watching the telly or news to find out what's going on more. I'm so behind. You mean, well, it's just because it's something that I'm interested in. I keep on top of it more, like on the internet. I look up at the Retail Gazette and BBC News business page and a few other places as well, because I don't like to get all my information from one place, so I've got a whole range of places that I look at. Lex Josh has put, these are great ideas, Charlie. Thank you very much. Perhaps 24 Jill put, Boots is really expensive, which is why it's losing ground. I would argue that somewhere close, Wilco is better for prices. Yeah, Boots back in the day used to make a lot of its own medicines. So the price of things at Boots used to go into research for new medicines or of how to make new medicines more cheaply, but just as good, and this, that, and the other. But it's changed a lot, Boots, over the years. I still love Boots, I really do. I still think it's a good symbol of trust and just making good stuff. I mean, touch wood. I mean, the owners of it now, I mean, they could always screw it up. Any owners of boots could screw it up overnight. But I really upped the dirt. And by closing stores, that's the beginning of screwing things up. Because that you start to lose the trust. These companies that think they can close stores to profitability are ridiculous. It doesn't work. You just lose customers' trust and faith in the brand. It's happening with Marks and Spencer's. And it's happening with Sainsbury's because they're closing stores. And it's going to happen with Argos. Well, it is happening with Argos and it is happening with Sainsbury's. The same that profits are down because they have to close stores. Then all the customers and shops get really miffed because it's like, well, I knew somebody who worked there who has lost the job. Or you've closed my nearest store now. So why am I going to go even further to go to your store? I'm going to go to the next nearest place. Because customers are fickle. I am. If this co-op that I live close by closed down, I'm not going to go all the way further to go to the next co-op, am I? Of course not. I'm going to go to the far closer Sainsbury's local. I'm going to go to, you know what I mean? I don't get where these CEOs get their mind process from. It's stupid. You cannot close stores to profitability. You've got to figure out a better way how to make them stores fit into the local community better of where they are. So if the local community has changed immensely and it's gone from being an affluent place to somewhere that's gone a bit down on its heels, you've got to start stocking it with stuff that them customers can afford. You see? It's as simple as that. Yeah, it'll cost a bit more money, but it will save you a lot more money in the future. And when that area picks itself up again, you've already got your store there. You can renegotiate the rent, absolutely. It's that simple. But the way it happens is some company in London will just say, oh, that store's not making any money anymore in Solihull or Mansfield. Let's close it down. It's like, no, you don't do that. Renegotiate the rent, absolutely. Downsize the store, maybe. But don't shut it completely. Unless the company is completely in terminal collapse. Anyway. Raps 24 Jill put, oh no, I've already read that one. Brett McLaughlin has put, just as an FYI, it's Donald and Aitchison, Dolland and Aitchison, not Donald. I know, I kept saying Donald, didn't I? I knew it was Dolland, but it's easier to say. Dolland is a bit of a strange last name, isn't it? I used to use Dolland and Aitchison, but Boots Opticians are rubbish. Yeah, it'll depend on area to area, but if it's a store they've taken over, I can imagine a lot of the original staff moving on. And the Boots Opticians standalone stores would be now probably just Boots own staff and whatnot. Amanda Adams has put, whoa, how many more shops are closing? It's sad to see. We are going to be a country of layabouts, so only order online because there's nowhere to go. Gaining weight, basically, we will be all fat blobs and never leave the house. So said our decent shops are disappearing. I know, yeah, and like I've already covered, it is just bad company managers and owners and everything who just seem to don't care because they still make their money anyway. There's a lot of gold to be made for them by closing store down and working for a couple of years. 4 to 7 years is usually the average CEO time. And then they get a big massive payoff. And it doesn't matter what damage they've done to the company, they get that big payoff anyway. You get paid for failure. It's a win-win situation. It's just madness. And at the bottom is the people who suffer. And eventually it's going to get to the point where you're right, it is just mainly going to be online. And then what happens is it'll drag people out of shops and they'll be put into fulfillment centres, as they call them. It's just warehouses, really. Which is then all them shop workers put a minimum wage, working much longer hours, much more exhausting work, because you're running around getting everything for what normally a normal customer would be getting. It will get to that day, because companies are just not doing enough to save shops and high street shops. The next video is Tuesday's Reviews Days. What did I review on Tuesday? I can't remember. No, I don't want that. Ben Stocks has put, oh, it was them matchmakers and that horrible dippy chocolate thing, wasn't it? Ben Stocks has put, the mint watchmakers, I think that's autocorrect there, isn't it? Matchmakers are after 8 mints and, The mint watchmakers and after 8 mints give me the Christmas vibes. The smell of minty chocolates makes me think of Christmas. I can relate to that. I think I only really buy after 8s at Christmas time, even though they're available all year round. Sally Buttons put, "Hi Charlie, the original 3 flavours, mint, orange and coffee, always reminded me of Christmas when I was a child, and we always only bought them then as a treat, and so they were extra special. Just my opinion, but I think sometimes it's not necessary to keep adding new flavours as they rarely can top the originals." Yeah, I can relate to that. Some chocolates are just sweets for Christmas, aren't they? Terry's All Gold chocolate collection. Just Terry's All Gold. They came in a box that looked a bit like Benson and Edges back in the day. And they always reminded me of Christmas. Let's try a red one now, shall we? So far, they're quite good. Although the lemon one could have been a bit more... I'll fall out. There's loads of purple ones. Some purple look just falling out the bag because there's so many purple ones. Let's try this red one. Tastes like strawberry, but tastes very close to opal fruits. Oh, no, it doesn't. No, it's got a slight bubblegum flavour, strawberry flavour. I'm salivating. Very nice. Nice, but it's Halloween, should have been a bit more sharper. And why has no one done any joke Halloween sweets? I mean, come on, Maynard Bassett's. I mean, obviously, which is Mondelez still, so it's Kraft. Why wasn't there some joke ones, like sprout-flavoured sweets and pumpkin-flavoured sweets and onion-flavoured sweets? Because I don't do Halloween, do I? There should have been trick sweets, not just treat sweets. What are they called again? Dead chewy. Whatever. Sally Button put, "Hi Charlie, the original three..." Oh, I've already read that one. Sonia's put, "The chocolate dip looked like tar. I am never sure when someone says excessive consumption may cause laxative effects. Like you said, how many would you have to eat for it to do that?" Exactly, it's a bit rank, isn't it? "Also, it happened to me ages ago. I don't think it takes that much, really. I was cracking up a bit when you were holding the breadstick as a cigarette. I hate the word fag, however it was used." Yeah, the word fag is absolutely nothing. Wouldn't like to be called that, obviously, but I don't find it offensive because it's either a piece of meat or a cigarette. Anyway, and the excessive laxative consumption thing. It was a bag of sweets this size, and I think it was some sugar-free version of Fruitella or something. And they ate the entire bag, and I was sat on the loo for about 3 hours. And it was horrible. It wasn't because I needed a poo. It was because I was just gassed up and I couldn't stop trumping. I mean, at the time, I was living in Hull. So the world only knows what downstairs thought was happening because I was just constantly breaking wind. It was really painful as well because it wasn't coming out easy because I had to sit on the loo to do it, you know, just in case. Which is too much information, but at least you're getting the full picture. And I just couldn't get off the loo. And as soon as I stood up, well, at one point, the worst point of it, I couldn't even stand up. I thought I was going to be stuck on the loo forever. It was that painful that I couldn't even stand up straight. I was like almost doubled over, like excessive wind. But then as you bent over, if you bent over too much, it really hurt as well. Oh, it was awful. And I had to say a bag of these sweets because I thought, oh good, the sugar free, that means I can have as many as I want. So yeah, the full bag. Never again. Katrina Cat has put, "Maltitol in the Jim Jams is quite toxic for the body. I would rather give a child a small amount of real sugar than that. I always feel ill after eating sugar-free sweets with maltitol in it. Natural stevia would have been much better." You know, stevia's got its problems though, hasn't it? But exactly, it's all about moderation, isn't it, Katrina Cat? Just give your kids a little bit of sugar. Instead of giving them an entire bag of sweets like this, just give them a few in their hand in a little paper bag or something like that and say, look, natural sweets for today. You know, moderation. Because kids don't know moderation. They've got to be taught it. So if you give a kid a big bag of sweets like this, they're going to eat them all, like I'm doing right now. well, not right now, but I probably will do. Quite nice. Susie Smart put, what does scrass mean? It means subscribe, comment, rate and share. Comment, rate and subscribe. The S's are interchangeable. The next video is Shamaretta. Now this is when I stuck together two of my favourite boozy drinks. I should have got some Midori as well, because that's nice. Pardon me, that's a melon flavoured liqueur. Pardon me. It's a green colour, it's great. Quite Halloween-y, actually. Martina Moran has put, it's the bubbles in the sham that may be fizzing it. Edit, just in the rest, lol. but no, mixing amaretto with baby sham is really nice. I was surprised. I'd definitely have it again, but I mean, nowhere sells. An Holland & Barrett advert just come on the telly, and it's some sort of offer. Ends on the 19th of the 11th. The 19th of the 11th? That's quite soon. That must be old. Martina Moroni's, Sally Button has put, straight away I'm transported back to the 1960s and 70s with baby sham. I had one of their rare plastic baby sham Bambis. No idea where my parents acquired it, but they were friends of a couple that ran a pub back in the day, so maybe it came from them. Wish I had it now for nostalgic reasons. Don't know what happened to it over time. They are also very collectible these days. Yeah, I always remember. I think my grandma had one, funny enough. I really think my grandma had one enough, and it wasn't big. It was probably about the size of this, actually, the Bambi. I don't think it was that big. Funny enough, you should say that. I'm sure they did. Yeah. But baby sham was at Christmas time. The little bit of drink you'd be given to by your grandma and your granddad. And maybe your parents as well, do you know what I mean? And you'd feel really grown up because you're drinking booze. But you'd only be given a tiny bit. And we aren't all running around saying, ooh, underage drinking then, do you know what I mean? It's all about being sensible. Was that all the comments? Just them three? Okay. Thanks for that, Charlie. I'll give it a go, said Robin McGregor. Right. Where are we up to now? Oh, and this will be the last one. And it is me reacting to something. What did I react to? It was when shops closed down. Vulturemas need to be kicked out, said Adolf the Chewbacca. I know, I was talking about Vulturemas. So when a shop closes down, you get people coming in who've never been in the shop before, or any branch of that shop, for that matter. And if they have, only once. And they've dusted off some old gift card that's covered in chip fat and dust from back of the cupboard somewhere, you know, probably been used as a doorstop or been in the back of the depths of the purses forever. And they'll start causing arguments at the tills, treating the sales assistants as if like something they're just trodden in. It's awful. It's an awful part of the company closing down. I went by Mother Care only just last night because before I got to Waitrose in Westfield, there was big, massive signs up. Saying store closing, and I didn't go in, but as you walked by, there are these signs at the top of all the racks saying 10% off. So there's not many of the massive sales yet, because the company itself is profitable still. It's just the UK stores have binned off, because they've not invested properly enough into them. There's been so many head office changes, you see, different ideas, then them ideas get binned off by the next CEO, then they get binned off for the next CEO. You see, that easily runs a company into trouble. And you can imagine customers going in there saying, where's the 90% off we saw in the newspapers? Blah, 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 blah. Michael George has put, my first ever job was at Clark's. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think you've ever mentioned them before on here. Clark's, I don't often mention them a lot. Losses have recently gone from 30 million to 80 million. Your thoughts on them? I personally think either folks or kids or older generations, they're either missing out on teen to middle-aged demographic. I personally think that either for kids or older generations, and they're missing out on teen to middle-aged demographic. Michael George, yes. Clarks. Definitely, I can remember going to Clarks a lot as a kid. Your first school shoes, you went to Clarks. Older people, they definitely go to Clarks. A problem with Clarks is, because I worked at Hot Shoes, didn't I, for a long time, is that they've really stuck in the old ways a little too much, and you're right, they do need to capture a middle market. For instance, they should have taken over a small, but very mid-range sort of shoe shop company, such as like when Faithless, or Faith, I can't remember the name of the shop now, went bust ages ago, and Debenhams bought them. Oh, gosh, this is about 20 years ago. They should have bought them, because you definitely need that mid-range there, so that they could easily have bought the company, kept it as the same name, just owned by Clarks, and then they could have still binned it off should they have needed to. But I think Clarks could have done a really good job there by capturing fashion shoes, but better made. Also, Clarks have suffered as well because they have been getting poorer quality product. Amanda Adams has put, I worked in Mothercare and I'm glad they are going. I was actually treated badly from management and members of staff whilst I worked there. Full of gossip backstabbers, and that's just the management. I had to leave because they spread my sexuality around the shop floor and made me feel so uncomfortable that I had to leave. That was 3 years ago, and I've wished for something bad to happen. Here they are going bad. Hearing that they are going is the best news I've heard, lol. Can't stand bullies in the workplace. Karma will always come round. Now, people from outside the company might say, what a horrible comment. But I can relate to that, Amanda, because I know that people are going to lose jobs. But it's hard, if you're working in a particular store where everyone was horrible to you, and it doesn't help if even the area manager's horrible as well, you can't help but feel a bit glad that something bad's happened. I mean, there's several companies that I've worked for that have gone bust that I'm glad have closed down because the people aren't being nice to me. And I don't feel sorry that the company's gone bust at all. Such as Comet, for instance. Comet was very horrible to me when I worked at Comet in Hull. It was an electrical retailer. I worked there for a couple of weeks. And when it went bust, I was glad. I mean, they gave terrible customer service anyway. And there was ripping people off as well with there was always on Watchdog on BBC because there was this doing this, that and the other, and there was misleading customers into buying things they didn't need and all that sort of stuff. So I was when Comet went bust. It was a company based in Hull as well. Because I worked in the call centre in Hull, I worked in the customer thingy. I still remember my line manager's name. It was horrible. I can relate to that. The thing is, Mothercare was such a big company. I'm sure there was at least one store somewhere where everyone was really nice. So it's sad for them. But in your case, yeah, I 100% get where you're coming from. Absolutely. Steeler666 has put, my local McColl shut down, which is annoying. I've always said, haven't I, if a company can't run a shop that sells food, there's something wrong with you. It's like Mike Coop with Sainsbury's losing all that money. If you can't sell something which everybody needs, there's something wrong with you. You're doing something wrong that is so basic. You should know your target audience. You should know your target customer. You should know what they want to eat and drink. You should sell it at the price you're expecting them to pay for it. And if you can't get that, which is actually very basic, they'll tell you different, but it's not. It's very basic. Then there's something wrong with you. For instance, if I was going to open a shop, say if I was to open a sort of mid-sized shop, you know, selling food as a supermarket, not a huge one, probably something on the size of half the size of a shop of Aldi, let's say. And I open that shop in Hull City Centre. Let's just start with Hull City Centre. Now, Hull is hardly full of rich types of people. It's a working town. It's working class. Well, it's a city. It's a city. But it's basically a city of shop workers and factory workers. That is mainly what it is. So I'm hardly going to open a little supermarket there selling high-end food. I'm hardly going to start selling pretentious, over-the-top, really expensive stuff because it's not a tourist destination of tourists who are going to go there with money to spend in such a supermarket. Okay, they might go to look at the art galleries that it's got in the old town and go to the attractions such as the Deep, for instance. But they're hardly going to be really rich types who are going to go and shop there. So that'd be so misplaced. I would open it as somewhere that would be more value for money, not tacky cheap, but value for money, so that if you got a pack of ham for £1, there would be a lot of ham in it, for instance. And I'd make sure that it was decent. If I was to open a similar size sort of supermarket in Knightsbridge in London, then obviously I'm going to go high end. You got to know what your target customer is in the place where it is. And places change. So maybe one day Hull becomes really high end. Okay, for all of a sudden, for whatever reason, all the rich people flock to Hull. Okay, and it gets really la-di-da and it all goes very up class and hipster and all the rest of it. So then absolutely change the shop. Okay, a few people get annoyed, they've frozen us out, but you go to what your target audience is and what is in your area. That is business, unfortunately. You go for the biggest slice, unless the smallest slice is lucrative enough. And then Steeler666 has also put, which shop are you on about? At the time in the video, it was Mothercare that had gone bust that I was mainly referring to, but you can affix that video to so many other different shops. That was that. That was everything. Thanks for watching. Please bell me, let me know in the comment section anything you want to know down below, and I shall reply on next Sunday outside. I'm not even outside. I haven't got a picture of a tree. To end with, I better finish off with the last flavour if I can find it in this. Oh my God! Right, so I've just tipped all this bag out. Right. Look at all the purple... Oh God, I'm dropping the purple ones now. I finally found an orange one, which is the only one I've not tried. But is the purple machine overacting or something? Oh my God, yeah! So I've only had one of each flavour, and I think that was the only yellow one. That was the only yellow one. I've dropped them all over again. It was! That was the only yellow one. I've only got one more strawberry one. There's two orange. Is it two orange? Yeah. So there was only two strawberry, as usual. Why is it only two strawberry? And two orange one, which, orange. So what, you know me, I find orange sweets rather boring. But really? All these purple in that bag. So much purple. There was actually another one that was stuck in my t-shirt. Well, let's try the orange one. Or was it apricot? Meant to be something, wasn't it? Bit bizarre. Apricot. Got a pinkish sort of tinge to it. That is apricot-y. Yeah. Or just apricot sweets that I'm not particularly fond of. Is it Frutella? No! This just reminded me of something. Do you remember opal fruits? I think it was opal fruits. Then they did a sub new version of opal fruits with different flavours. This tastes like one of them. Different companies that work with them. Yeah. I'm sure it was Opal Fruits that did it. I'm sure it was. And I never liked them because the apricot one was my worst one. It tastes exactly the same as that. So, the flavours themselves, I would have been really happy. But actually, I'm not now. I'm not now. Because that's the last ones left of the other flavours. And I've already eaten all the yellow ones by having one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 purple. And you know what? I didn't buy just one bag. So, hang on a minute. I'm going to get the other two bags and we're going to see if it's the same story in all of
I'm back.
Whilst I went into the larder, that makes it sound really glamorous, the larder. It's just a big pull-out drawer thing. Do you remember when I reviewed the Fox's sweets ages ago? I've still got them. And some of them have leaked out and made this horrible goo at the bottom look. So this jar is not going to be usable at all. Oh, God, look, it's even got the mint one. Let's see what it smells like inside. Oh, it stinks. Oh, have a smell of that, future YouTube. What's happened there? It's only sugar. Why does it smell so bad? Oh, it's almost like the mint sweets have gone off and they've mixed with the fruit. Oh, I didn't think it was going to be that bad. I just opened it right now. I had to put the lid on that. I was going to put all these sweets in there. Why have I put them all? Oh, I was going to put them all in. Ew. Anyway, I've got the other two bags. Let's see if it's the same story there. Oh, God, what a stench. This one looks like it's got a much better mix. I'll just tip them out into my t-shirt. Not quite. Oh, reverse story on this one. This one's only got three purple ones, so clearly. I think the machine must have been not working very well. I've got a much better mix in this one. I've got a lot more strawberry ones in this one. And a lot more of the lemon ones. That one's a better mix. That one's all right. Can you see? Anyway, look, that's a better mix of sweets. Oh God, no, it's rolling off. Oh, don't go down my trousers. And let's see what's in this next bag. I don't know where I'm going to put all these sweets now. And, oh, this one's a better mix as well. Yeah, same mix as the second bag. So it must have been the first bag being a bit dodgy. Oh, got a much better waft of the sweets from this one. Yeah, so it's blending in with my Crash Bandicoot top a bit, but that's a much better mix of sweets as well. Now I'm absolutely covered in sweets. Thanks for watching. Scrass, bell me. See you when I see ya. Bye. The sweets are nice. The sweets are nice. I like some. Oh, the apricot one's my worst. It's the orange one of the bag, if you know what I mean.